to invite people to Islam, to let you Christians know that Almighty God Allah is only one Lord. He's not a three in one. He's not a triune God. Jesus never said he's God, never said worship me. And also he did not come to die on the sin of mankind. I can prove to you. So now, I'm asking, do you be, are you a three in three? We have to go by the concept of God first.
Okay.
Yeah, because if you want to know, if you want to, you believe in one God.
One God.
Okay. But you're not, you don't believe in Trinity.
No, I believe God to be one.
Okay, what I'm saying, you don't believe in Trinity. Because there's people who, there are Trinitarians and non-Trinitarians.
Christ is the word of God into human form.
Yeah.
The Spirit is God that we can't see around.
Mm.
But order is one. One person, one God, maybe three different manifestations.
Okay, we got to, that's what I want to know. Yeah. See, so in Islam, the concept of God in Islam is that the Quran has got 114 surahs, equally chapters. From the first surah, Surah Al-Fatiha, to Surah Nas, 114 surah. If you want to know about the concept of God in Islam, you go to the 112th surah, which we call Surah Ikhlas. And in this surah, I'm going to quote it to you and give you a translation so that you know. You go to the Bible, then...
Can I have the Quran?
Copy the Quran. I'll get it from... I didn't bring
okay,
a copy.
Next time,
I'll
next
get
time.
A Quran. I'll get a copy from there, over there. So in this verse, in this surah, Surah Ikhlas, 112th surah, I would be that. I'm saying, say, "Qul huwallahu ahad." Say, "He's Allah the One, Allahu Samad, Allah the Absolute Eternal, Allah who is self-sufficient, upon whom we all depend." Lam yalid wa lam yulad. He begets not, nor is he begotten. Wa lam yakul lahu kufuwan ahad, and there is nothing unto like him. Nothing unto like him. Unique. He's not a man. And we Muslims worship him alone, without any partner. We don't worship the creation. We worship the creator. Now, what we have, issue we have with the Christians is this. We have commonalities, but we have parting of ways. This is when you Christians say Jesus is begotten Son of God, John 3:16, and when he said Jesus is God incarnate, John 1:1, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. 14 says, and the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. According to you, this is Jesus, fully God, fully man on the earth, God incarnate. And Christians worship Jesus. Well, Jesus never said he's God, never said worship me. So we have a problem with that. Why do you worship Jesus? When Jesus never said he's God, when he never said worship me. Why do you call him God? Why do you say Jesus and Almighty God are co-equal, co-eternal? Because you believe in Trinity. This concept of Trinity, the word Trinity is not in the Bible. And the only place, the only verse closest to this concept of Trinity in your Bible is in the first epistle of John 5:7, which says, for there are three that bear record in heaven, the Father, the Word, and the Holy Ghost, and these three are one. That's it, nothing else. And if you read the Revised Standard Version, they chalk it out. These three are one, it's not here. 32 Christian scholars of highest eminence wrote this book. So this is the problem we have with you. And several verses in the Bible, Jesus makes a distinction between him and Almighty God. Why is the Christians don't ponder these verses? And in the Old Testament, Almighty God said he's the only one Lord, him alone deserves to be worshipped. We are from here. When Jesus said, John 14:28, my Father is greater than I. Explicit. Why is the co-equal, co-eternal there? When John 17:3, Jesus said that the only true God is Almighty God. He said, and this is eternal life, that they might know that you are the only true God and Jesus Christ whom you have sent. In fact, this verse alone is enough for us to question you. Only through God. The only mean, what does only mean in English?
It's one.
Yeah, so it's one. Yeah. And Jesus said that. Yeah. Yeah, but you believe that Jesus is God. Can you prove to me Jesus is God? Before you come to the Jesus dying for the sin of mankind, I'll debunk that. Prove to us that Jesus is God. Prove to God that this Trinity.
He said, do you have a copy of the Quran? You know when you ask for a
copy? Let me finish. We digress, as I'm saying.
No, he asked for a copy at the start.
We gave him the copy. Okay, no, we're going to digress.
Did you read the Quran? Or did you want the
I
copy?
I've never read it.
That's the point. You've never read it. So how can you disprove something
that,
you've
that's
never
why
read?
He was saying.
No,
was like,
no he's listening. That's the thing. That's what I'm saying. He said.
He's never read the Quran. You've never read it.
No.
How are you going to disprove
it? He said. We said we are on the truth. And they are on the truth, that's the thing. So we're debating, so I'm going to debunk that. That's what I mean. So what I'm saying, okay, you believe in the concept of Trinity. Can you prove that these three?
We all, human beings, we all reason. And I'm also an intellectual. So when he was talking and he was bringing his argument and all that, that's why I just went straight in my head.
He's listening.
I need to read it.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. Yeah.
So I say, can I have?
Yeah, yeah. Which I appreciate. That's the thing. Copy of the Quran.
Because
yeah.
Because if you don't have all the concept and all that, you can't stand on
absolutely.
The ground to argue to.
Yeah, I agree with you.
Yeah. Another one. Come on, guys. Mm-hmm. Now
he never said he studied the Quran.
This is what I've seen as Christ being God.
Mm.
It's like God taking His word and putting it into a human person, and that's what is Christ. That's what I've received. Now debunk that. If the Quran debunks it,
That what that you.
What did you say?
No, let me finish. That
Christ
is the word of God.
That God is the word of that Christ is the word of God. So God took His word and He put it into a human being that we call Christ.
Yeah.
So the word of a person and Him are the same.
That wasn't your claim.
No, hold on. If the word, okay. What about the heavens are the word of God? Can I quote the Bible? It said the word of God is here.
Yeah.
That said that. Yeah.
No. What was you saying?
Like, what I'm saying? Is that the word of God? Okay.
Brother, you don't understand what you're doing. You just said that I want you to debunk that the word of Christ is not the word of God.
No.
Of course, we believe the word of Christ is the word of God because we believed in the Bible. We believed in the Jews' book. What the whole point of you coming here was to make him see your proof in why Christianity overthrows Islam. What he's done,
okay.
He made statements to you.
Yeah.
Saying,
okay. Let me deal with it. I know. I've been doing it for 10 years. No. Don't worry. I'll go gradually. In my own way.
If you
want to take over.
One,
but one debate at a time. I know how to address it.
The second question, saying, yeah.
So let him, you know, if you do like, you know, you've got to digress.
Believe that Christ is God. Tell me so that I can debunk him. That's what I'm saying.
Yeah, let me finish. He says, you get the word of God. He said, you know, baby, and they all said that. Christ is the word of God. That means that Christ is God.
Christ is the word of God. Therefore, is God.
Yeah, therefore, is God.
Yeah.
The word of God means God. Okay, the heavens are the Bible said the heavens are the word of God in your Bible.
Yeah.
What? Do you worship the heavens?
No, the heavens is not God.
It's the word of God. Impression. But no, it said the word of God. By the word of God, the heavens were made. Can I quote that to you?
Yeah.
This is in the, if you read it in the, in the book of Psalms.
In the book of Psalms.
By the
word of God, the heavens were made.
Yeah, yeah. So do you, Psalms 33, 6 to 9, do you, what about heaven then? That means that you worship heaven as well as God?
Yes.
But the Quran explains this. If you read Golos Quran, come to the Bible, if you read Golos Quran, it is mentioned in Surah Nisa, chapter number 4, verse number 171. It says, all people of the book, all Jews and Christians, do not go to extremes in your religion and do not speak lies against Allah, but speak the truth. The Messiah, Isa, Jesus, the son of Maryam, the son of Mary, was no more than a messenger of Allah. And his word, which he bestowed on Maryam, and a spirit created by him. So believe in Allah and his messengers. وَلَا تَقُلُوا صَلَاسَا Don't say Trinity. إِنْتَهُ كَيْرَ لَكُمْ Desist, it will be better for you. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is only one God, only one Lord. You know, the word of God cannot be God himself. You understand? So when Christians say that, I said, now, where is Jesus now? Where is Jesus now? You say it's in heaven.
This is what we believe is in heaven.
It's in heaven.
Yeah.
Where is he in heaven, according to the Bible?
Christ ascended in heaven.
In heaven. Where is he in heaven, according to the Bible? Where is Jesus in heaven, according to the Bible?
According to the Bible?
Yeah.
He died, he rose from the dead, and he's not sitting
okay,
at
the Bible,
right hand.
He's sitting what, at the right hand
at the right hand of the Father.
No, he said he's sitting at the right hand of the mighty God in heaven.
Yeah, of the
mighty
one.
God.
Yeah,
in,
of the
in,
mighty
yeah.
one, of the power of God Almighty.
No, okay, this is in the Gospel of Luke,
yeah.
Chapter 22, verse number 69. We see that Jesus, Son of Man,
yeah.
is seated at the right hand of the mighty God in heaven.
Yeah.
So if Jesus is sitting down at the right hand of the mighty God, how many gods are there in heaven now, I'm asking you? Because you believe one God, but you believe there are three. How many are in heaven now? If Jesus is seated at the right hand of, he said, mighty God in him. Mighty God. So, yeah, I'm coming to the Holy Spirit, yeah. And where is the Holy Spirit? But tell me, Jesus is in heaven, sitting down at the right hand of the mighty God.
Okay.
Tell me his position there.
Give me your Quran. Let me read the part where you said.
it's in Al-Baida, yeah? Yeah? In the... Sorry, okay. In Nisa, Surah Nisa, let me go ahead and read it.
There's some concept that you can't understand fully. Maybe the Trinity is something that is a mystery.
How can it be a mystery? It cannot be a mystery.
You go to work every day.
When it can be a mystery, when God himself said, you see, the Christian, the problem with the Christians, majority, you go to church, you believe what the pastors are telling you. Huh? John 14:9, he that has seen me has seen the Father. John 10:30, and the Father are one. Isaiah 9:6, for a child is born. On and on and on. That, but you haven't studied the Bible. The problem. God himself said, you know, in the book of Exodus, chapter number 20:3-5. Do you know it? God said, you shall have
no other God but me.
So why do you? But do you understand that?
But not him.
So what does that mean?
The Father. Him alone is God.
Who?
God Almighty.
So how did Jesus become God then? When he said, "You shall have no other gods beside me. You shall not make for yourself a graven image or any likeness of anything that is in heaven above, or that is in the earth beneath, or that is in the water under the earth. You shall not bow down to them or serve them, for I, the Lord your God, am a jealous God."
Yeah.
So why do the Christians bow down to Jesus and worship Jesus then? This is very serious. See, we Muslims are trying to reason with you. Isaiah 1:18. No, in your Bible, Isaiah 1:18 said, "Come, let us reason together," says the Lord.
Look, brother, I mean, I understand you.
Yeah, yeah.
So, I understand you fully.
I'm going to give you a copy of the Quran.
I want to read this.
The Quran, which one? The one what I just said. The Quran.
Give me a copy. I'll get a small one for me.
I'll get a copy.
English.
Yeah, yeah, I'm gonna copy. Yeah, I'm gonna get a copy for you. Yeah, yeah. Which is
all the key verses that you want me to check.
Okay, yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Can I ask you a quick question?
Let's finish. It says something first. Let me finish. Yeah, exactly. I will.
Where it proves that God is one.
Yeah. Okay.
The deity of Christ has been debunked.
Yeah. On the end.
The key verses. Because I can read all of it in maybe 1 week. Next week, I'll meet you.
Yeah.
I'll go my own time. I'm a big guy. Let me just check myself.
Okay.
And then we'll talk. Because these are the things that I got in my head for a long time.
That's the banker will take time. That is a first.
These guys, genuine. Step. You're very genuine. It's good. Exactly.
Because I can see you. You are genuine. You got three Bibles. You studied it.
Mm.
Give me a small Quran.
No, this is what I'm saying. Yeah.
You have to read it in a neutral state. Yeah.
No,
yeah. That's what I'm saying. Another brother here, we had the same thing in Nigerian. You know, we had a debate. He even said to me, "I'll never become Muslim." We tried. And later on, he read the Quran. Another brother spoke to him, and he took a shahada. So what I'm saying exactly, we give you a copy of the Quran, and I'll do that. Yeah.
Is your main language English?
And
yeah, I speak English.
With open mind.
Open my mind.
He's got. He looks like open mind. Yeah. What's your name, Van?
Diane. You're talking to me. I'm not an open-minded person.
Oh, you can see. No, it's open-minded.
You can see me.
Yeah.
The way you debated it, I'll check it for myself.
Yeah.
I'll come. With an open mouth,
I'll get a copy of the Quran. Get a copy of the Quran. Give it to you. We do that. Read it. That's what I did. That's why I read the Bible.
Yeah.
So
because you got free Bible. I don't even have one Quran.
Yeah.
So you.
Yeah. No. Inshallah. Yeah. Give it to you. Maybe to you.
Listen.
I'm gonna get a copy of the Quran.
Keep me. I'll go and get it.
Okay. He's gonna get a copy of the Quran. Inshallah.
Stay here.
Get a copy. And I'll go in there and show you the verses. And then
you finish doing your thing. Yeah. You know, you said you will beat me.
He will beat me. No,
let me finish.
What's your name?
I stay quiet, Diane.
Diane.
When you get your Quran, read the chapter, Mayhem chapter.
Yeah, we've got to go there. Yeah.
Read first Mayhem chapter with open mind.
Do you know why you said he'll beat you? Do you know why?
Because it's not free Quran.
No, because you never read it.
I never read it.
Mm-hmm. I'm asking you a question. Let me ask you a question.
Yeah.
When you read it, are you going to read it as a Christian, as someone that's already got a mind? Are you going to read it as Diane, as someone that don't know what the truth is, that's looking at something that I want to know what the truth is?
Okay, first of all, I'm a logistician. I mean, I like logic.
He'll be listening. He's a good listener.
I'll read it with an open mind.
He's open mind,
What's your name?
Mohammed.
Don't even worry about like I'm going to be...
I'm worried about you.
I'm not going to read it with a critical mind already set. I'll read it. I heard
you believe it was with God's power, only with God's guidance and God's power that he allowed you to move away from there and come here.
Yeah.
So do you think there's a reason for that?
Yeah.
Now that, to me, that reason is this brother has clearly gave you some evidences today.
I'm
going to give my number as well. That's it. So I've got my card here. My last card, I gave it to a brother here. So,
if you call me to that stand, you know all these brothers, they won't care, bro, because they know that we follow the truth.
I heard no problem.
Why were they pulling? No, they were pulling his back. They were saying, no, don't go there.
They were scared.
They were scared.
Who's going to say go?
No problem. Because he's a Muslim, he knows I believe in Allah. And I'm not
we'll give you a number, we sit down, got brothers here. Yeah. We know another Jamaican brother, Rivat, and Abdul Razak. I'll come here, we know Abdul Razak. Yeah,
he's a nice guy.
Abdul Razak to Nigeria. We talk,
Ask God to guide you to the truth. Mm. Yeah.
We come to the restaurant where I've got right now. We sit down, we talk. On your day off, me and one, we love that. From away from the crowd.
He's so sincere, bro.
Yeah, listen, don't take a week, take a month.
Take your time, yeah.
Read it again. Mm. There are phone numbers and what have you. If you have any questions, ask them,
I'll give you my number, I'll got my card. My last card. I'll give you my number.
I'll
give you my number.
Put it in.
I've got a pen. You got a pen? No, let me give you.
We'll check it out. We'll check it out.
We'll check it out. Okay. That's the thing.
Before you go as well, listen. Yeah. You said that I don't believe in the. You believe in. You think it's one a mystery, innit?
Yeah.
You go, it's a mystery, innit?
Yeah.
So, what's a mystery? Would you say it's better to believe
in something?
Once again, would you say it's better to believe in something factual?
Yeah.
Mysterious?
No. 0, 7, 9.
So, if I give you two statements,
why would God?
One. If I give you two statements, 0, 7, 9, 8, 0, 7, 8, 9, 2, 2, 1. Here. Yeah. There. Let me call it so that I can store yours as well.
They make themselves look.
How do you spell your name? Your name?
D-A-Y-A-N.
D-A-Y-A-N.
Yeah. That's Lamin.
Yeah, Lamin. Yeah. D-A-Y-A-N. Okay. Let me call it.
D-A-Y-A-N. If you leave here today,
let me store it.
If you leave in here,
D-A-Y.
If you
Lamin. Yeah, Lamin. D-A-Y-A-N. Yeah, that's it, yeah. Yeah, that's it. D-A-Y-A-N.
You don't associate partners with that guy.
D-A-Y-A-N.
D-A-Y-A-N.
I would say that.
But I think it's important to say both of us. Yeah. I want to say it with you. I only believe in one God, and I don't believe that there's anything associated with
that. Furthermore, if you were born in a Christian family, and you are raised in a Christian family,
I understand that.
I understand. I'll tell you something now. I know a brother that was born into a Sikh family, and when he became a Muslim, he had to lie to his parents in Ramadan because he couldn't eat at home. He said, I'm on a gym diet. Like, this brother went through a hard time.
No, he wanted a copy of the Quran, and I gave him my number. Want to know more about that? Yeah, finish. We know about that's the thing. So inshallah. So I'm gonna meet up, inshallah. We're gonna meet up, and then I'm gonna call him, inshallah. Muhammad Lamin. It's very sincere. The other scream, but you got brothers, you know that they want to look into the Islam, which is alhamdulillah. So it's sincere, the man is sincere. You can tell it's good. Yeah, good number. It's good, yeah. They're trying to prevent, which is good.
They were pushing you away.
Which is good.
What I'm saying is don't just let him get away.
No, go his number.